What is meant by difficult anesthesia and tracheal intubation? Have you heard of the word difficult airway? In this video, I'm going to tell you what exactly that means. This is a video on YouTube from a hospital in southern part of India. And I'm just going to walk you through what exactly happens in this video, trying to explain what difficult anesthesia is. Now, this patient walked into the operation theater to get anesthesia. A mask is put on the patient's face to give oxygen, and then they're trying to put the electrocardiogram leads to monitor the heart. Whenever there is a difficult anesthesia patient, it's customary to have two people trained in anesthesia to do these cases because these can be very challenging. So here in this case, I see two people standing at the head of the patient. This patient already has an IV in on the right arm, propofol through the IV to get the patient off to sleep while the mask is being held on the face to give oxygen. And this oxygen is important because normally room air has mostly nitrogen and there is a lot of nitrogen in the lungs, and during anesthesia, all the nitrogen has to be washed out by giving an oxygen mask, and this is called denitrogenation. And this helps to keep the patients safe. Now, as you can see, the eyes are trying to close and the patient is trying to go to sleep here. So this is called the breathing bag that the doctor is squeezing, that is to give oxygen and maybe some anesthesia gas too into the patient. Now, once the patient is off to sleep, they're not breathing anymore and the breathing is taken over by the anesthesia doctor. They're still in the process of making sure the patient is getting deeper under anesthesia, because when the breathing tube has to be placed, the patient has to be in a certain plane of anesthesia in order to prevent any complications before getting the breathing tube in. Either the patient has to be completely awake or has to be in certain plane of anesthesia to have the breathing tube in. If done in an intermediate stage, that can lead to problems. Now, they're still waiting probably to get that depth of anesthesia, and this comes by experience and seeing all the things that is going on there. Looks like the doctor is saying that we should wait for 4 minutes. Maybe they give a muscle relaxant medicine which takes about 4 minutes to work. As the patient is getting deeper with anesthesia, they're watching the monitor, they're making sure everything is stable in terms of the heart rate, oxygen saturation, blood pressure. All right, the doctor is indicating something there. Okay. He is saying put some lubrication on the breathing tube so it's easy for the breathing tube to go in. So the white thing that the doctor has in his hand is called a stylet. That instrument is called a laryngoscope, and after the laryngoscope is passed, he might actually pass the stylet in. I'm wondering why they're not using fiber optic intubation. Okay, so that seems to be a difficult case because he's not able to open the mouth enough to get the stylet in. So far, if you're finding value with the video, make sure to hit that like button there. If you have any questions so far, do hit in the comments below. I'll try to get to you as soon as possible. All right, so the laryngoscope is going in again, and then the doctor is trying to get the stylet in. So the stylet has to go through the trachea, after which the breathing tube can be put on the stylet to put it inside the trachea. So they're still not able to get it in. So this is a really difficult patient, as you can see. Now, that's not unusual for the anesthesia doctor to decide to sit, because they have to change their position to get an optimum view, because this is, after all, a difficult anesthesia patient. So it looks like he might give another try. The laryngoscope is going in back again. So the mouth opening is very small, so that's why he's having difficulty in getting the laryngoscope in and getting a view of the trachea. All right, now instead of getting through the mouth, he's actually going through the nostrils, which is another option of getting the breathing tube in, hoping that he get a better view of the trachea going through the nostril. I'm still a little surprised as to why they would not use a fiber optic intubation in this case, which is what probably I would have personally done. Or maybe a video laryngoscope, which is another type of laryngoscope, which gets a better view of the trachea to get the breathing tube in. So it looks like this time the stylet is actually inside the trachea, and now they're actually railroading an endotracheal tube onto the stylet to go through the nostrils into the trachea. So the breathing tube can be put either through the mouth or through the nostrils. You know, sometimes it can also come from the chin here, but that's very rarely done. Okay, so that's the process of railroading the tube. So that tube was probably too big. So he's actually picking a smaller size tube to put it in. Okay, the tube is going in through the nostrils. It is probably in the trachea now. The laryngoscope has come out. Okay, the nurse is putting some air into the endotracheal tube cuff. So there is a tight seal of the endotracheal tube inside the trachea. And now they're attaching the breathing circuit, and then they will ventilate to make sure the tube is actually in the right place inside the trachea. So let's see if that's the case. That can happen, you know, Aneem, if the hook is not tight enough, so that can pop off. So it's important that someone is watching that. The presence of endotracheal tube in the right place is confirmed by seeing an end-tidal carbon dioxide on the monitor, seeing chest rise. Alright, so it looks like the tube might be in the right place. I can't say it unless I see the monitor, I see the chest rise. But looks like it is. So that's why they're going into the next step, which is actually taping of the endotracheal tube so it stays secure in its place. Alright, so they're putting a second tape on just to make sure it is really secure, because again, this is difficult anesthesia. If the tube comes out for any reason, that can be a problem, especially in the middle of the operation. You see, he has a pretty bad lesion in his mouth that might be contributing him not to open his mouth and causing the anesthesia to be difficult here in this case. Alright, so this is one way of how anesthesia is given in a difficult case. If you're interested in more videos related to anesthesia and operation, do check this playlist out. I've also left them in the description below. If there's any other videos you want to watch, do leave them in the comments below. Take care, stay safe, and I'll talk to you soon. Thank you for watching.